Hello, I'm Michael Jones, Director of Education at the Conservatory of Recording Arts and Sciences. We're here today for a live event with our friends from SSL. They are on their SSL Truck Tour. I'm here with Mark and Dan from SSL, a group of my students who are involved, Dave and Tony, the engineers, on the session. So we're doing a live broadcast event from our control room here in Tempe, Arizona. We are featuring a four-piece live band, which we're going to go visit them in here in a few minutes. But I figured I would take this time to chat with our friends from SSL. So, Mark, tell us more about the SSL Truck Tour that you guys are involved in.
Sure, absolutely. So we have a demonstration vehicle, which is currently outfitted with one of our AWS 948 Delta consoles. And we travel around from place to place. And it's a great way to just show what SSL is doing these days.
Very cool. We will be visiting that truck here in a matter of minutes, so you all get to take a good look at it. So, Dan, are you the man who moves the mobile unit?
I am. I'm the driver and the barista, and I sometimes like to play with audio gear, too. So
it all works out for the best.
It does.
Well, I can't thank you guys enough for coming to visit with us today. Tony, you're the engineer on the session today. Technically, what are we up to before we start looking at the live room and the mobile truck outside?
Well, this is currently our 11th cycle that's in this classroom today, and we incorporated all of the elements into this clinic / SSL tour. We happen to have an AWS 948 ourselves, actually two of them, so we thought it'd be fun to, you know, daisy chain them per se, and have this great presentation. So this is the 11th cycle. It is their band clinic. So part of the duties here is to pre-production, note-taking, set up all the microphones, make all the patches, you know, an experience of what it would feel like to be a second engineer, pretty much.
Yeah. Very real world. So, for those of you that are not familiar with the Conservatory of Recording Arts and Sciences, this is one of four of the SSL consoles we have in this program. We have an E and G series from the good old days, and then we have two of the 948s, which are online for us for just a little bit over 2 years now. So let's move on from our control room adventure now and take a look at the live room. So we'll be back with you in just a minute. So here we are in the live room with our high-level professional musicians. Today, we bring in our clinicians who have been involved in our institution for many, many years. These guys do great work for us and help the students continue their journey into the real-world adventure of being audio engineers. So thank you guys for being here today. So Tone, let's continue our technical tour. So what else do we have going on in here today?
A lot of fun things, especially if you're into microphones. Currently on the drums, we're doing our local microphones on all the drum components, you know, kick, snare, and toms. Some special things we have. We have a nice outside kick mic, the Blue Mouse, and we have a Telefunken M80 on the snare drum there. Our overheads are from our friends from Mojave, the MA100s, which we really, really like. All right, we're gonna turn this way a little bit.
Okay.
And we have the MA100s there on the drum overheads with the center microphone, the AEA R92 for a nice ribbon flavor, all patched through wonderful SSL gear as we enjoy very much. We have Ted here playing keys for us today. So how's it going, Ted? Very good. Flanked to Ted's right is Ra playing bass for us today. And then something interesting we're doing with Tony. Tony's got a nice guitar pedal rig happening here, some nice goodies there. But with Tony, what we're doing is we're sending his feed into an ISO booth in Studio F, where the guitar amplifier is isolated from the rest of the microphones in this room. We have a tasty Neumann U87 and an AEA R84 ribbon mic that just love to work together. So from a technical standpoint, that's a synopsis of what's going on.
Real guitar sounds for a real guitar player.
Real pedals, all right. Real amps, real guitars.
All right. Well, in a very short few, we'll be able to bask in the glory that is this four-piece today. So these guys will be revving up here in a few minutes. We're going to start making our way down towards the SSL mobile unit now, and we'll be able to look at this from the other angle. So let's move, you guys. Okay, guys, we're back online and we are now in the mobile. All right, we are now in the mobile unit. So now I'm going to get some deeper input from our SSL technicians today. So guys, tell us more about the truck and what we're up to today.
Sure. The truck is currently based around our AWS 948 Delta, which is a 24-channel 48 input console.
Let's step aside and let the camera take a look.
Yeah, absolutely. So in addition to it being a fully configured analog console, it is also a 24 fader DAW controller that I can flip control between the analog and the DAW just by pressing a single button. I think you guys chose this maybe even for that reason in particular, amongst other things, but I don't want to put any words in your mouth there, but the truck, the inside here is actually designed by the world-renowned Russ Berger, studio designer, who's designed quite a few studios in his day. You may have heard of him. Russ Berger did the whole truck. Absolutely, yeah. And he's quite the designer. He did a great job on the truck. We're very happy with it. Originally outfitted with our C10 broadcast console, which is why you see a bunch of speakers in the front. Yeah, we actually have 5.1 monitoring set up, which the AWS is capable of as well. And then, of course, these little Genelux here are for our mini monitor, so we can switch between the two. We also have a rack of gear in the back there, which incorporates some of our new network I/O products. We have our Matty Dedante bridge. We have a stage box with 8 mic pre's and 8 outputs. And we also have an SDI to Dante device, which is actually how we are feeding audio to the console right now.
Okay.
Now, in discussing how we were going to do this today, because this is a demonstration vehicle, it's not really designed to do recording, although we can do so. We were thinking about the best way to get signal from inside the studio to over here, and we came up with Dante as the best solution, because we're only getting a feed from a single Ethernet cable, and that plugs right into our Dante system, and we can route signal all over the place, so it's pretty cool. In addition to the Dante stuff, we also have our X-Rack, which is our modular analog outboard system, and our summing device, which is Sigma, our remotely controlling summing units.
I could not even walk past the X-Rack without being drawn towards it. You know, it's almost impossible for any engineer to do that, right? And I'll expand a little bit on the technical that it took to make this happen today, so that we're running from our F studio on our 948, but that studio is also tied into our G studio. So both of our 948 control rooms are connected. So we're running the snake from our main control room that's taking the input from the band to our other control room, and there is an analog snake feeding the conservatory's mobile truck, which you probably saw on the cameras. We were making our way to the SSL truck. So that's how we're taking the analog input into our mobile unit, and the Dante protocol, or the Cat5, is running from our mobile unit into this mobile unit. So quite the technological achievement to run through 1, 2, 3 consoles and rooms before we get to the destination, which is the force, which would be the truck.
Absolutely. On top of that, there's actually no generation loss between any of the signal that's going on here. And what we're hearing here in our truck is exactly what they get to hear inside the studio.
It's real time, no latency. No latency to deal with, no issues with that as far as time. So what we're hearing right now, if we walk back into the studios, it's exactly the band performing, but it's running through quite a bit of cable to get here.
Quite a bit, but it's not a big chunk of copper. It's just, as you said, a single Cat 5.
Joke about the fact you can buy that at Home Depot, right? hard to get to Canary or Megami at those kind of outlets.
I think they might be on to something shortly.
Just a matter of time. Right?
Absolutely, we would use it, of course.
So Dan, you're probably not pulling a lot of copper with the truck these days, huh? Dealing more with the fiber and with the Cat 5 and things like that.
Yeah, we actually have very minimal copper here in the truck. We do have our SSL AlphaLink Live R converters up here in the front, which are converting the digital audio to analog to feed the AWS. But other than those short runs from that rack to the desk, everything in here is basically either copper or Ethernet. So it makes the truck a little bit lighter. Yeah, we don't have any kind of problems like that. And it certainly makes my life easier as the truck engineer to not have to contend with analog snakes and patching. As you can see, there's also no patch bay in here. We're doing everything within the Dante domain.
Yeah, it makes everything nice and robust, and copper tends to oxidize and tends to break, and so maintaining the truck, which has now got, 90,000 miles on it? Yeah. This is now its fifth trip around the United States. Keeping it up and running and working really well, which I'm very proud to say that, our AWS console has not had any problems with it. And, all the bumps and you had to go through some bad driving almost off road out in California near Santa Cruz. that was some bad stuff. But, everything held up really, really well.
Well, yes, bouncing your equipment around in a mobile unit is always risky. As they say, do not attempt this at home. all right, you guys. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to come visit with us today. So we're going to go back live to our live recording room coming off of our Studio G. And let's just sit back and enjoy our four-piece band. So thanks very much. I'm
I have some things hard panned, as you have here. He's a hard pan. Guitars are slightly less hard pan. A bunch of EQs in where you can see all the EQ in lights. If it's red like this, no filter currently being used. We have dynamics being used on a couple of things. So dynamic one, which is over yonder, is on the inside mic of the kick drum. And then also dynamic two is on the bass guitar as well. I'm sure Tony's doing a little bit of compression and dynamics over here, but we're doing a little bit more just to get...
On a couple of them, Dave, right, we're bringing them back on the instant returns. And the reason why we're bringing them back on the instant returns is so that we could bring it into a source fader. So, and the way we did that is instead of going back. Thank you. So right now we're streaming live and it's pretty much all band shots. So if you guys got one more, this should cover it. Just keep going. Drop a marker in.
Go up to the top of the channel, and you see there's a phase left and a phase right. You see it? Okay. So as soon as he starts kicking, we'll be right back.
Again, it's going through that distressor, and you're seeing the gain reduction, but it's focused more on the attack of the drum. That's why I put it on the other side. So, let's see. And then we also, in the rack, we have those, the radial Comet compressors. You guys see where they're at? They're those green ones there? Yeah. Thanks, guys. Chill for a bit.
Wow. Thank you, guys.
That was really cool. Nothing like live music in the middle of the day, right? One of the things that we like to do here at the Conservatory is as much of that as possible. Something about the energy and excitement of live performance in the studio gives you all the control you could ever want. So once again, I would like to thank our friends from SSL for coming with us today and the SSL Truck Tour. So Mark, thank you so much for coming.
Absolutely. We're glad to be here at the Conservatory. You know, you guys are one of the premier institutions for professional audio education, and we love partnering with you guys because you're always keeping us on our toes as to new challenges and stuff like that. So it's a lot of fun. Thank you.
Great. Thank you very much. And Dan, thank you for, you know, getting it here. And, you know, please stay safe on the roads of America out there.
Will do. Absolutely. Thanks to you guys. And thanks to the band. They sounded awesome today. And all these students who helped us mix. And, you know, always sharp students here at CRAS. So it's always our pleasure to come out here.
All right. Well, thank you so much. And to all of you out there that are watching us today, thanks for joining us. And we'll see you next time.